you can be generous, because don't need to be a millionaire to be generous. You can start with what you have.
Mr. George,
yes.
Today we are talking about philanthropy.
Yes.
And so many people want to know, Mr. George, what is this philanthropy? What is it?
Well, philanthropy is a word used globally. Mm-hmm. And you hear people call themselves, George Washiri philanthropist. Mm-hmm. Manu Shadari a philanthropist. Philanthropy is anyone or anybody who cares about the uplifting of other human beings. A philanthropist, DJ Covenant, is anybody who cares about making the world a better place. How do they do that? They care about that when they give their money, when they give their time, when they give their talents, when they give their energy towards something that uplifts the well-being of humanity, the well-being of making the world a better place. That is basically philanthropy. Yani, unatoa pesa kwa mfuko, and you want this money to support the livelihood of other people, or that money to support the well-being of our group, or the well-being of somebody else. That is called philanthropy.
And such as someone is saying out there, is asking, I want to adapt to this lifestyle. How can I adapt to this lifestyle, Mr. George?
Well, this is very interesting, DJ Covenant, that I said earlier that being a philanthropic, you must not have money. Because you can be philanthropic with your talents. You can adapt and say, my talents are going to serve maybe young people. My giftings are going to serve maybe old people. And then, of course, if you have money, thank God. So when you have money, you can say, part of my money will go towards a certain cause, like what we are doing this evening. You know, we said some of the resources God has given, Optiven Foundation, we are going to support the shoshos, the boda boda. You know they are getting out of accidents.
Yes.
So you can be able to adapt this philanthropic lifestyle. And how do you do it? Number one, start giving pole pole. And for the parents out there, start teaching your children how to be philanthropic. What after you like a container. In our Greek, it was called kalimo.
Kalimo.
Whereby if there's some change, you put those coins there.
Home bank.
Home bank. Once the home bank is completely full to capacity, open it up. Tell your child, we are now going to Soweto Children Home and give this money to that particular home. Once we practice that lifestyle with our children, by the time they are age of DJ Covenant, by the time they are age of Gibbs, by the camera, these guys are going to be philanthropists, that, just like George Washiri. But many times we don't teach our people how to live this lifestyle of philanthropy. Very, very important. Number two, DJ Covenant. If you want to lead philanthropic lifestyle, always be kind. We are living in an environment whereby people are very selfish. Yet they know that all these things we have, they are temporary. Be kind to people, whether it's in that particular office that you talk to people, whether it is in your family, be kind to people. Kindness means you smile to people, you love people, you care about people, even when driving. You know, one day, you know, I was doing some exercise, and this guy came driving very fast and splashed water on me. I said, wait a minute, this guy is unkind. So you can be able to activate that kindness and you become a top philanthropist, the DJ Covenant. Yes.
And make sure you tell a friend and tell a friend. They need to understand what is being a philanthropy, and also they need to know how to adapt even to being a philanthropy. And we'll be discussing more of that. That was point number two.
Yes. Number three, to adapt to this philanthropic lifestyle, practice giving. Yani, as a person,
just practice.
Don't wait. You just practice giving. You can literally give your old clothes. I know most of our viewers, they have a lot of items in their houses. Many shoes. Yet that particular second-hand shoe is like a new shoe to somebody somewhere. So practice giving. Because one of the things that we have, especially people from Africa, we are not very generous. And we need to be taught how to be generous. And that's why for us at Optiven Foundation, we sensitize people. You can start giving. You can be generous, because don't need to be a millionaire to be generous. You can start with what you have. Get a mentor, who can take you through on how to do it. And that's why DJ Covenant, we are here. Get a mentor like George Washiri to tell you how can you really be a philanthropist. And I'm happy that we have empowered many, you know, buying our books. We tell them, once you buy this book, you're a philanthropist. And I have seen people now started giving. And then the number five, just be a steward.
Be a steward.
Be a steward. Man, even the shoe you are wearing is not yours. Be a steward. What you have belongs to the Creator, belongs to the universe, belongs to your God. Be a good steward. And a good steward eats and also let others eat. And that's why DJ Covenant, that's why even our own projects, we don't just come to this particular project, subdivide land and sell plots. No, we don't sell plots. We settle people. We come here and check. People require a good environment. So our way of working is philanthropic way of working. We are able to give more value than what people pay for. That's what we are talking about. The same with your families. Are you giving more value, or you're just doing it because it is your responsibility? In your own career, are you philanthropic enough to give your giftings in your job, in your career, that you're doing extra? And once you do extra, I can guarantee you more innovations come and more better things happen.
Mr. George,
yes,
we have now adapted to that lifestyle. Now, what are the benefits? I have now adapted. Yes, these things, I've started doing them, I'm learning these things. What are these benefits of a philanthropy?
What are the things that I have seen personally? You know, this is what I will say it, because I have seen it.
Yes.
Every time you become philanthropic, you live longer.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. What do you want? My own mentor, he is celebrating 92 years, Manu Shadaria. And the guy is still advising government. You live longer. So if you're there, you've been worried that you're going to die young. Man, start giving. Once you start being philanthropic, you will live longer. Number two, DJ Covenant.
At 92. Advising government.
He's advising His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta. At 92.
He's your friend.
Some of the people here, they are only 50 and they look 90. Because you're not giving. DJ Governor, the reason for success of Optivian is basically giving. Once you give, doors open. Number two, when you become philanthropic, there is joy that comes from within.
Joy.
You know, you are making people joyous. Like now you're going to greet mamas here, give them unga and starve and sikuku. As these mamas are getting happier, they say happiness is contagious.
Yes.
By the time George actually goes back home, by the time DJ Covenant goes back home, you are also joyous. Let me ask you, why are we on this earth? We are on this earth to be happy.
Nothing.
It is basically to be happy. Why do you buy a big car? You want people to see you so that you feel nice. You don't need to buy a big car. You only need to be philanthropic. And you feel nice.